table runner. I have embroidered two beautiful designs. The designs are sold on the Oriental Embroidery site. The address is oriental-embroidery.com. At the center of the table runner, I have also used one of the Oriental Embroidery site designs. But this is a part only from one of the large curtain designs. Because those designs you can embroider the part you want and then stop the machine. That's what I did. And they are very beautiful. Very, very decorative designs. And on the elephant designs, they have used their special technique, creating shadow effects in the embroidery. It's very, very beautiful. I don't want the end of the table runner to be straight over. I want to do it. I have measured 10 centimeters up each side. And I have marked the center at the bottom. So I simply cut between the center and the marked point 10 centimeters down on the side. Yeah. I think it looks a bit more professional having in a different shape at the end, not only straight on both the ends. I want to use another fabric around the whole table down there. And I have found a matching fabric. So I just cut. I will use, I think 7 centimeters is the right size. So I cut the edge of the fabric to be a straight line. 7 centimeters I use. I have to cut one part for each side of the table runner and one part to be used at the end. I have to cut 3 strips of fabric, 7 centimeters. I fasten the edges on the sides of the table runner, fasten it with pins, and now I can do the stitching. I soon finished stitching side number 2. Like always, I do the ironing. At the edge of the table runner, I don't iron the seam allowance from the center like this, like you usually do. I want the seam allowance to stay under this fabric number 2. Be sure to put the seam allowance under the decorative fabric. Now I will cut this extra fabric at the end. I will follow the line on the main fabric and then cut it. I have now cut the fabric so it follows the main fabric. Now we will do the ends. Then I will do the stitching. I have stitched the first of the 4 parts at the end. And now I have to iron it. And I have to cut it again to follow this line of the main fabric. I of course also have to cut it to follow the line at the edge and do exactly the same way at the other end of the table runner.
Table runners, I always use the bedding because then I think they get a more
professional look. I put the batting onto the table and then lay the table runner with the right side up on top of the batting, and then I fasten around it with pins. Then I cut it. I don't cut it exactly the same size as the table runner, because I will fasten it with small zigzag stitches around the edge, and then it sometimes stretches, and because of that I want to cut it close to the zigzag stitches after having fastened it to the table runner. I have not fastened the batting on to the table runner using zigzag stitches. And now I will cut close to the edge, like this. I have cut around it, and now it is time to put the lining on. So I put the lining onto the table with the right side up. Then I place the table runner with the right side down. And fasten it all around with pins. I have put pins all around except for 20 centimeters opening in one side to be able to turn it inside out after having stitched around it. I have stitched the parts together, and now I have to cut the seam allowance a little bit. But in the open space in the side, you don't cut any seam allowance, because then you will have difficulties getting perfect edge when you have turned it inside out. All corners you have to cut straight over, but be sure not to touch the stitches, because then you will get a hole in the corner. We do this cutting because if we don't, we will get lumpy corners, and that is not beautiful. I have now turned the whole thing inside out, and to get nice corners, I simply go into the opening in the side with my scissors, push the corner out. The next thing we have to do is to put pins through both fabrics around the edge, because we have to do the stitching close to the edge, because we have to do the stitching close to the edge. And we will also stitch in this line between the two fabrics. And now I will do the stitching, millimeter and a half from the edge. The stitching around the edge is done, and now I will stitch exactly in the line between the two fabrics. Table runner is finished, and as a final touch I put a tassel on. I fasten it with an ordinary needle and thread by hand onto the end of table runner, one each end, like this. On AskTheCrafter.com you also find a video showing how to create a tassel.